The country's top soldier has placed the commander of Canada's special forces on leave indefinitely with pay following revelations that he wrote a letter in support of a soldier found guilty of sexual assault. Amid mounting anger, Lieutenant Gen. Wayne Eyre, acting chief of the defense staff, apologized for his handling of the situation and said Marge, Gen. Peter Dorr will immediately turn his command over to the Special Forces Unit's deputy commander and proceed on leave, according to a statement released Sunday. Eyre said a sense of betrayal was intensifying the suffering of many in the Canadian Armed Forces. CAF, it has become increasingly clear to me that MGEN Peter Dorr's actions 4 years ago around sending a character reference are causing division and anger within the CAF, Eyre said. I apologize for increasing this pain. The move comes just days after Eyre announced Dorr would be rotated out of his role leading the Canadian Special Operations Forces Command, CANSOFCOM, next week, in advance of his original departure date this summer. But there has been outrage from within the ranks of the armed forces and on social media that Eyre didn't go far enough by allowing Dorr to move on to his new position early as Director General of International Security Policy. The decision was seen as a difficult one for Eyre because of Dorr's stature in the military. Eyre said in the statement that he's taking further action to help morale, in the interests of CAF cohesion and morale, and to maintain the operational focus of CANSOFCOM, both national imperatives. Yesterday I directed that MGEN Dorr immediately turn command over to BGEN Steve Boyven, the current deputy commander, and proceed on leave, Eyre's statement reads. Kevin Sharmoon said he was shocked to hear that Dorr, who at the time was his superior in the Special Forces, had written the character reference letter for Major Jonathan Hamilton, a soldier found guilty of sexually assaulting Annalise Sharmoon on two separate occasions. Hamilton was also found guilty of physically assaulting Kevin Sharmoon twice. During the sentencing hearing, the judge noted that letters from high-level military personnel described a man of great character before being engulfed in post-traumatic stress disorder from multiple deployments to Afghanistan. Hamilton was sentenced to probation rather than jail time, but the next year, he was sentenced to 3 years in prison after a second, unrelated, sexual assault trial. I believe that through this experience, General Dorr lost his moral authority to lead the Special Forces, Kevin Sharmoon said in the original interview with CBC News. Dorr penned an open letter earlier this week apologizing for his handling of the case. As all of you have likely read, I failed a member of our command, he wrote in an open letter obtained by CBC News. Instead, when approached by the perpetrator in this case, I recognized empathy with his personal struggles and responded emotionally. And while my intent was purely driven, it is clear that the impact of my actions was profoundly harmful to the victim and her spouse. Moreover, I did not consider how my actions would be viewed by other silent survivors of sexual assault in our ranks. Eyre's statement said Dorr's return and future employment will be determined and communicated in due course. I have confidence in MGEN Dorr as an officer who has accepted full responsibility and has learned from this tragic case. However, the needs of the institution must take priority. Eyre also promised to examine the practice of character reference letters in legal proceedings. It's not unusual for a military member accused of sexual assault, or the Defense Council, to seek and obtain character references from commanding officers for the purposes of sentencing. While I do not expect these measures to right the wrongs of the past, or ease the sense of betrayal felt by the Sharmoon family, we must keep learning and ensure such situations are not repeated going forward. In doing so, we must always have the victim's perspective at the forefront and be accountable for our actions, the statement concludes. We must do better. Kevin Sharmoon complained about the handling of his case in 2017 to the chief of the defense staff at the time, General Jonathan Vance. In a letter viewed by CBC News, Vance wrote that he had looked into the matter and found Sharmoon's objection has merit, and was inconsistent with his efforts to stamp out sexual misconduct in the military. Vance wrote that action would be taken so that incidents of this nature will not be repeated without severe repercussions. He promised to include direction and training materials explaining how support should be provided to military members awaiting trial and sentencing for sexual misconduct. However, when CBC News asked for a copy of that directive, the Department of National Defense said it does not have a copy of a directive or any other information to provide at this time. suggesting Vance didn't follow through with the promise. The move to place Dore on leave comes days after the federal government announced yet another external review, led by former Supreme Court of Canada Justice Louise Arbour, to look into the issue of sexual misconduct in the military. The previous report on the subject, by former Supreme Court Justice Marie Deschamps, recommended an agency independent of the chain of command for reporting misconduct. That agency was never created, and instead a sexual misconduct response center was formed that is independent but only provides advice to victims. It's possible changes are going to happen in organizational changes, where authorities will need to change. There possibly might be legislative changes as well, he told CBC chief political correspondent Rosemary Barton. Sir John also said he would act on interim recommendations put forward by Arbour rather than wait for a final report. A Canadian Forces Reddit page garnered more than 230 comments on Saturday in response to a CBC story about Eyre allowing Dore to move to his new job early. Some expressed outrage and disappointment that Eyre wasn't taking a stronger stance. Others wrote that being rotated out of a command post was a serious enough penalty.